Hey, what's up guys, this is Nair Sheikh from blogdude.com, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to create a beautiful and professional blog. So let's first see the demo website which we have already created. So guys, as you can see, this is the demo website which we'll be creating in this video. At the top we have a logo. I'll show you how to create this logo without using any professional softwares like Photoshop or anything like that. I'll also show you how to put this favicon up there. Then we'll create these different menus, about us, contact us page. Then at the home page, as you can see, there are different blocks at the left hand side, and at the right sidebar we have some recent posts with the thumbnails. Then we have categories, then a Facebook like page, and then social icons. Now let's see how a post looks like. So just click on the post. Okay, so the post is obviously the most important thing in any blog, because this is the main data, this is the main thing you're publishing. At the top, as you can see, this is a title, then some text, then I'll show you how to put this image, then this image also, then I'll also show you how to put this blog quote, these bullet points, and I'll also show you how to put this color to different font. And then we'll see how to put a permalink to, or a custom link to, any text or any image. So let's see how a category looks like. For example, when we click on make money online, this is a category I have created. So as you can see, different blogs that depend or that belong to one particular category will show up. So let's see the about us page now. Oh yes, so this is our about us page. As you can see, I have put some color to the title and to this thing also, and then at the left side we have some text, and at the right side we have a image. I'll show you how to do all these things. So this is really simple and professional. Now let's see our contact us page. Okay guys, so this is our contact us page. At the left side there is a simple and a very nice looking contact form. At the right side we have some text, the get in touch message text. Then we have used some beautiful icons for the address, phone and email. Then we have business hours. Obviously you can edit anything you want in this column, but I just created this thing, so I'll show you how to create this thing and edit this thing. Okay guys, so this was our demo, and also remember, the website which we'll be creating is 100% mobile friendly. What I mean by that is it adjusts to your mobile automatically. You don't have to scroll right and left to, you know, just to view that thing. It is mobile friendly. When you view this thing in mobile, as you can see, the menu shifts over here, the three lines. When you click on that, this is your menu. All the images and the text automatically converts according to the resolution of the device you're using. So this is a mobile friendly website. This is SEO friendly, and we'll be using WordPress, which is the most easiest way to create a website. So let's get started. Okay guys, so to create a website, we need a hosting plan and a domain name. For both hosting and domain, I prefer the hostgator.com. So you'll find a link in the video description below, which will redirect you to this particular page where you can select among the three different plans. This is the hatchling plan, a baby plan, and a business plan. Basically, we are going with the baby plan because it has got unlimited domains, whereas in hatchling plan, you can only register one domain with the hosting account. So select the baby plan and click on sign up now. Okay, at the top, we have to enter our domain name. If you already own a domain name, then click on this. I already own this domain, and put in your domain name. So because I already own the domain name, I'm putting my domain name over here, blogdude.com. Then as you can see, we have already selected the baby plan. Now we have to select the billing cycle, 36 month or whatever you want. I personally prefer to go with 12 months. So click on 12 month and select any username of your choice. It can be anything you want. And a security pin. Your security pin must be 4 to 8 character long, may only contain numbers. Now here, put in all your information, your billing information, your email address, first name, last name, company name, whatever it is. If you want to pay with PayPal, go with PayPal, or you can pay with a credit card or a debit card. Put in the information of your credit card or debit card over here. Then scroll down and untick all these things because we don't need this thing. And suppose you want or you need these things in future, you can obviously buy this thing or purchase these things later on. So we don't need now. So for now, we don't need all these things. Here we have a coupon code. At present, we are getting a 40% discount. So if you're getting a 40, 50% discount or 60% discount, you don't need to put my coupon code. Just click on the link in the video description below to HostGator and your work will be done. Here we have enter a coupon code. So just go there, delete this thing and put in webdude45 and click on validate. As you can see, when you put in webdude45, you are getting a 45% discount, which is a great discount. So after you have completed filling all the fields, just tick on I have read and agree to the terms and conditions and click on checkout now. Okay, so once you click on checkout, you'll receive a email on your registered email address. Just open this thing and here you'll find all the important things which are needed for the website. For example, your plan, which plan you're using, your control panel link, your username, domain, password, name servers. Make sure you save this information somewhere because this is very important. So first, what you have to do is just click on the control panel link and open this in a new tab. And now put in your username and password and click on login. So once you have clicked on login, this is the cPanel. This is your control panel from where you will be controlling your website. So at the top, as you can see, it is WordPress installer. Just click on that because we want to install WordPress on our domain name. Okay, so once you get this window, select your domain name from here, the domain name on which you want to install WordPress. So my domain name is this one, and make sure you leave this directory empty. Click on next. Now put in any blog title you want. For example, I'm putting create website with Nayyar. Admin user should be Nayyar. First name Nayyar, last name Sheikh. Select your admin email. Make sure the admin email you're selecting is active and you have access to that email address, because all the information, the important information like the password, the username, you'll be getting on this particular email. Okay, so once you have done that, just tick the terms and services agreement and click on install now. Okay guys, so as you can see, it says installation is completed. You're getting the installed to domain, username and password. So just click on this link and open this link in a new tab. It shows a 404 page not found. Don't worry, this is really common because the WordPress is not yet been installed on this domain, so it takes some time, around 4 to 5 minutes. So just keep on refreshing the page. Once you get it, we'll continue. Okay guys, so now our WordPress has been installed on our domain. So what you do is just click on here, and after your domain, put in // wp-admin and press enter. So once you do that, just copy your username from here and paste it over here. Similarly, copy and paste your password from here and paste it over here and click on login. Okay, so once you're logged in, this is how your dashboard looks like. And the first thing we are going to do is change our password. So for that, just hover over here, which says Howdy Nayyar. It will say your name, Howdy, whatever your name is, and click on edit my profile. And at the bottom here, you'll see new password. Click on generate password. It'll generate a new password for you, but we want our own custom password. So we delete this thing as it is very tricky for us, very difficult for us to remember, and put in our own password. Okay, it says it's a weak password. Click on confirm use of weak password and update your profile. Now what we have to do is change some general settings. So clear at the left side, you'll see different menus. Over there, you'll see something called setting menu, hover setting, and you'll see different options. Now click on general options. Now, as you can see, this is a site title and a tagline. Make sure you put in site title and tagline according to your website that befits your website. For example, when you see my website, the site title is Blog Dude and a tagline is a guide for all the bloggers. When you hover over my website at the top, as you can see the site title and the tagline. So you can also put in site title and tagline that befits your website. So let's put in something. So for site title, I'm putting Blog Dude, and for tagline, create a blog. Okay, so this is what we have to do over here, and click on save changes. Now again, come to settings, and under settings you will see something called permalinks. Just click on that, and you have to select this post name permalink, because this is the most SEO friendly, because we want our blog to be shown and to be indexed on Google, which is the most important thing, I guess. So make sure you select the post name and click on save changes. It says your site is currently displaying a coming soon page. Once you are ready to launch your site, click here. So because we are creating a demo, I'm creating a tutorial. So I'll always need to check the website for the changes. So I'm clicking over here to make my site live. Okay, so once you have installed the WordPress, let's see how our website looks like now. So hover here and open this page in a new tab. Okay guys, so this is how our website looks like now, but we want to create and make something like this. So for that, we'll need to install a theme. So come back to your dashboard. At the left side, you'll see something called appearances, hover appearances, and select themes. A great thing about WordPress is that you get so many beautiful and professional themes for free. Now click on wordpress.org themes, because we want to install a free theme. And in the search bar, type in Poseidon, P-O-S-E-I-D-O-N. And here, as you can see, this is the theme you want. So just click on install. So once the theme is installed, it will ask you to activate. So click on activate. Okay, so we have successfully activated our new theme. Now let's again come back to our website and see how our new theme looks like. So when we refresh the page, this is how the theme is. It is really simple and very good, but still it misses all this stuff. So what we have to do is now start creating posts, sidebars, menus, logos and all. Okay, for that, come back to our dashboard, and first we have to install some plugins. So hover plugins at the left side and click on add new. Now we have to install some plugins. I have written all the names of the plugins in the video description below, so you can check out all the plugins. So these are the different plugins: social icons by Theme Grill. So first, okay, so this is our first plugin, social icons by Theme Grill. So click on install now. It says it's been installed. Now click on activate. Okay, so it is activated. Again, hover plugins and select add new, because we want to add more plugins. And the next plugin which we want to install is Site Origin Widget Bundle. So type in Site Origin Widget Bundle in the search bar, and this is the one we want. So click on install now, and again click on activate. Oh yeah, so similarly you can install and activate all the plugins which are given in the video description below. The list is given in the video description below. So once you have installed all your plugins, we are ready to create our first post or our first blog. So again, at the left sidebar, hover post and click on add new. And here is the title. Here the title will come. It says enter title over here. So let's see how we have created this blog. So the title is powerful page template. I'm just copying and pasting this. You can put in your title that befits your, you know, content, that is good for your content. Then what we do is click on toolbar toggle. It gives us more options. Now let's copy this text because I don't want to type everything and waste your time. Okay, so once you have copied that, okay guys, so now let's see how to put in the image over here. So what you do is click on add media and upload a new file. So for that, click on select files and select the file you want. So this is the file, or this is the image I want. So click on open. Now click on insert into post. So as you can see, the text is coming down because this is not aligned properly. So click on the image, and as you can see, you'll see different alignment options below. At present, it is set to no alignment. What we have to do is select align left. So as you can see, the image has come to the left side and the text is now on the right side. Now we have to add this image, full width image, that is for stretch across the post. So for that, again click on add media, upload files, select file. So this is the image we want to add. So select that image and click on open. So once you have done that, click on insert into post. So as you can see, this image is coming very small. So what we do is select over here and drag it or extract it till we find the perfect size. So we have taken this image also. Now what we do is add some more text. Okay, so I'll adding all this text. Just click over, just copy and paste it over here. So now let me show you how to put the text into block quote. As you can see, this text is block quoted. So for that, what we do is select the whole text which we want to quote, and at the top click on block quote. So once we do that, the text shifts towards the right, which confirms that the text has been, you know, added to the block quote. Okay, now we have to add some bulleted points. So let's see how to do that. Just copy again, and now suppose we want to put a bullet point to this text or to this sentence. What we do is select this sentence and click on bulleted list, or if you want to make it number list, so click on numbered list. Okay, similarly for all different text. Okay, so this is how you create a bullet point or a number list in WordPress. Now we have to see how to color the text and put a link to the sentence or to any particular word. So again, copy this thing, paste it over here. So as you can see, it is not colored. So suppose we want to color this sentence red. So what we do is click on text color and select red color. Similarly, you can do it for all the different text. And this is already linked to some different page. So suppose we want to remove the link. So what we do is just click on this link, and here it says remove. Click on remove. So as you can see, that link has been removed. And suppose from here, for example, we want to link this thing, this particular word. We want to link this particular word to some different page. So what we do is just select this word. At the top, we click insert or edit link and put in the link. Suppose I want to now redirect this sentence or this word to my website. So I put in my website and click on apply. So whenever somebody will click on this sentence, they will be redirected to my website. So this is how it happens. So once we have created the blog, our post, at the right side, we have to Select a category that befits the post. At present, we haven't created any category. So what we do is click on add new category. So we can create a category from here only. Suppose we want to create a category called make money online. Although this doesn't belong to this particular category, but just for the purpose of showing you guys, and press enter. So the category has been created and this thing is already ticked, which means this post belongs to this particular category. Then coming down, we have featured image option. So click on set featured image. Now we can select a featured image for this particular post. What is a featured image? For example, let's come back to our homepage in the demo website. So as you can see, this is a featured image which shows besides the post. So for that, just click on upload file and select any featured image of our choice. For example, I'm putting this one. So select this, click on open. Now click on select featured image. Okay, so once we are done with that, just click on publish. Okay, congratulations guys, because we have successfully created our first post. So let's see how our post looks like. Just open this link in a new tab. Okay, so this is a problem. We'll fix this problem. Now come down, as you can see, the image is shifted. We have put this image, block code, colored this thing, and as I showed you, this thing is linked to my website. When I open this link in a new tab, my website opens. So just cancel this. This is how easy it is. Now we have to remove this thing. So for that, what we do is click on customize at the top, and at the bottom we'll see something called theme options. Click on that. General settings, we can choose the sidebar. We at present we have the right sidebar. We are happy with that. It says enable sticky header feature. What is that? For example, this is our header, the sample page, and this belongs to header. When we scroll down, the header disappears, but we don't want that. We want a sticky header like we have in the demo page. In the demo website, when we scroll down, the header remains with us. It doesn't go away. For example, wherever you scroll, the header is always at the top. So for that, if you want that, just click on enable sticky header feature. Now here we see post layout, single post. It says show featured image as header image. So what we do is hide featured image. Okay, so we have successfully done that. So once you have done that, just click on save and publish. Okay guys, so we have successfully created our first post. So similarly, you can create any amount of or any number of posts you want. Now what we do is we say this sidebar. For example, here we have recent post with a thumbnail, but here recent post is just some text or line. So we want to make it attractive, something like this. Also, we have to remove all these things, archives, comments, meta, and put in some awesome stuff like category, a Facebook like widget, social icons. So for that, again, come back to your dashboard, hover over appearances and select widgets. So at present we have 6 different widgets. We want the search bar, so we don't do anything with that. We don't want this recent post. So what we do is just click on delete. We don't want this recent comment. If you want this, you can keep it, but I don't want. So what I do is delete this thing also. I don't want the archives, so delete this. I do want the category, so I don't do anything with this. I also want to delete the meta, so let's do that. Now let's see in our demo website what we have. We have a recent post with thumbnails. Okay, so for that, let's search for recent post extended. So here is our recent post extended. As you may remember, you might have downloaded and installed a plugin called recent post extended. So this is what it does. It adds a new widget to your website. So what we do is click on that, make sure sidebar is selected, and click on add widget. Okay, so we don't have to do anything with this. We just have to change the size of this. So instead of 45 by 45, we have to do it 45 by 65. Once you're done that, scroll down and click on save. Now minimize this thing by clicking over here. Now again, let's see what we have. We have categories. We already have our categories over here, but the category is below recent post. So what we do is click and hold category and drag it down. So as you can see, this is how easy it is. Now we have to add a like box. So again, come back to the widgets and search for Facebook by WebLizard. So once you find that, click on that, make sure sidebar is selected and click on add widget. So you can put any title over here. For example, here we have like box. For that, we put in like us on Facebook. Okay, you can put in your Facebook page URL. For example, my Facebook page URL is facebook.com/blogdude. Show faces, I'll say yes. These are the faces, so we say yes. Show live stream, I'm going with no. Now we have to set the widget width and height. So our widget width will be 364 and our height will be 560, which is good. Now we have to create a Facebook ID, a Facebook app ID. So for that, you'll see a link in the video description below. Just click on that link. Okay guys, so once you click on that link, you will be redirected to this page. So what you have to do is at the right top, just hover my apps and click on add a new app. In the display name, you can choose any display name. I'm choosing blogdude. Contact email, I'm putting in my email address. You can choose any category. For example, I'm choosing education and click on create app ID. So once you come here, at the left side, you'll see something called dashboard. Click on dashboard. And here is your app ID. So just select this ID and copy it. Come back to your widgets and delete this thing and paste in your app ID. So once you're done that, just click on save. Okay, so we have successfully created this thing. Now we have to put in some social icons. So for that, again, come back to your widgets, scroll down and find something called social icons. Okay, here it is. Select that, make sure sidebar is selected, click on add widget. And here you don't have to do anything. Instead of social icons, you can put in any title of your choice. And we have to put this size as 32 pixels. And you can, you know, put in your custom Twitter address. For example, my custom Twitter address is twitter.com/realnear. And for Facebook, again, blogdude. You can also add links to other social networks. For that, just click on add icon and put in the link address. It will read, it will automatically create a icon for you. For example, I want to put in my YouTube account. So what I do is copy and paste in my YouTube link. And as you can see, the icon is already automatically created. So as similarly, you can add as many items as you want. So for now it is enough and I'm click on save. So we have successfully done with all the widgets. Now what we have to do is come back to our website, refresh, and let's see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, the changes has taken place. You can see my Facebook page over here, social icons, category, and because we have created only one post right now, so we are seeing only one post. So now let me create some different dummy posts so that we can redirect those posts to different categories, and after that we can create our menu. So I'm pausing this video. I'll be creating a few posts and then we'll continue. Okay guys, so I have successfully created all the post, the dummy post. So once you do that, as you can see, your website now looks really beautiful. Now what we have to do is create a about us and a contact us page. So let's see how our About Us page looks like. So this is our About Us page. So similarly for that, what we do is there are two ways of doing that. Either we hover over New and click on Page, or we go back to our dashboard and at the left side we'll see Pages menu. So hover over Pages and click on Add New. In the title, type in About Us. Now we have to create something like this, a page like this. We are at present at Visuals. So what we have to do is click on Page Builder. As you can see over here, it is Page Builder. So click on Page Builder. Now click on Row because we want to add a new row. So once you do that, stretch this thing to 65 into 35. Okay, fine. It is now fine. Once you've done that, click on Insert. What does this mean is we have created a row and we have created two columns among that row. For example, this is a row and this is two columns. One column is this, another column is this image. So our first column is 65% and the third column is 35%. So this is what it means. So click on first column and click on Add Widget. Now scroll down and select Site Origin Editor. Once you've done that, hover Site Origin Editor and click on Edit. Now we have to put in this text. So what I do instead of typing everything, just copy it from here and paste it over here. So once you have pasted over here, as you can see, here the color is different of the title. So what we do is just select this title and click on text color and put in any color of our choice. Similarly for this thing, you'll also note that this text is bigger than the regular text, because how to do that? So for that, suppose you want to increase this text, select this tag and over here it is selected heading 1. So now we have this paragraph text. So this text is similar to this tag, but we want to make it bigger, heading 1. So this is how we do it. So once you've done that, click on Done. Now select the second column and again click on Add Widget. Now scroll down and select Site Origin Image, because now we want to add an image in the next column. So for that, again click on Edit, choose Media, upload the media. So this is what we are going to upload. Select. Now click on Set Media. Image size should be full. Now click on Done. So once you are done doing all this thing, just click on Publish. And now let's see how our page looks like. Open this page in a new tab. So guys, as you can see, our page really looks awesome, but we don't want this thing because we don't have this thing in our demo website. We don't have the sidebar. So for that, again come back to your page and here you'll see template. So it is set to default template. What we have to do is select full width page. So once you do that, click on update. Now come back to our page and refresh the page. Okay, this looks awesome. So we have successfully created our About Us page. Now it's time to create our Contact Us page. For that, go back to your dashboard. At the left side, you'll see this contact menu. So click on contact menu. You'll see a contact form is already created for us. So what we have to do is just click on this shortcode and copy this thing. This is what we have to put in our page. Now again, hover over pages and click on add new. Put the title as contact us. And again, we have to go to Page Builder. So click on Page Builder, click on Add Row, and we want this 50-50%. So let it be. Click on Insert, select the first column, and now click on Add Widget. Now select Site Origin Editor. Now edit this Site Origin Editor and just paste in the code. This is how easy it is. This will automatically create a contact form. For example, this contact form, we don't have to create it, it is already created for us. We just have to paste in the code. Once you're done that, click on done. Now again, select the second column and click on add widget. And now select site origin editor. Now click on edit. Now just go back to the demo page. The link is obviously given in the video description below the demo page, and copy all these things and paste it over here. Now you can edit this text accordingly, whatever you want to put in the get in touch message. Why we copied it? Because we are getting this beautiful icons without creating these icons. So for that we have copied this. You can change the timing, whatever you want, change the address, phone number. So this is how you create this. Once you are satisfied with the information, click on done. And again, in the template, instead of default template, we want full width page. So select that and click on publish. Now let's see how our page looks like, contact us page. Open this in a new tab, and as you can see, this looks really beautiful, professional. Okay, so now what we have to do is create different categories. As you may remember, while creating this particular post, we already made a new category, make money online. So that was the first way, or the one way of creating a category. There is another way. Let me show you how we do that. So for that, come back to your dashboard. At the left side, you'll see post, hover post, and select categories. Here we have to put in the name, and the category will be created accordingly. I have automatically created many categories like affiliate marketing, features, make money online, YouTube. You can create another category. For example, you can name that category as Facebook or anything you want, and just click on add new category. So this category is created. So similarly, you can create as many categories as you want. Now what we have to do is change our header. As you can see, for that we want a logo, the beautiful logo like this. So as I told you in the beginning, I won't use any professional softwares like Photoshop or anything, and I'll show you so easily how easily you can create a logo. For that, open a new tab and type in logomaker.com. The link is obviously given in the video description below. You can follow that link. Hey guys, so once you open this website, what we have to do is search for graphics. For example, you want something like a butterfly. So what you do is just type in butterfly and click on enter. As you can see, you can get many different logos, many different icons, colorful icons, black and white icons. You can select whatever you want. For example, I like this one, so I'm selecting this thing. Now keep this thing small. We want height of around 50. So as you can see, when we resize this, we can get the height and width. Make sure the height is fit to 50 pixels. We can also add some text. For example, for that, just click on over here, text, and type in anything you want. For example, butterfly. And again, do the same with this one. Make sure height is 50. Okay. Now keep this thing over here beside this, and we can change the font from here, but I like that able font only. So what I do is keep this thing, and we can also change the color of the font. For example, as you can see, we can change the color of the font. We can also make some different changes, like we can make it decorative or whatever. Okay, so once you're done that, click on crop. Okay, now crop this image. Make sure the height is only 50, not more than that, so that you can get a perfect logo for your website. Once you're done that, just click on save logo. So we have successfully created a logo without using any professional software or something. Now let's insert this logo into our website. So for that, come back to your website and here click on customize. Now select site identity and here you'll see an option for logo. So click on select logo, upload image. So this is the butterfly logo we just created. So click on open and select. It will ask you to crop the image. Just do it like this and click on crop image. So this is how it looks. And we are also getting the site title. We don't want that. So untick this, display site title. Okay, that's gone. Now we have to upload the fav icon. As I said, this is the fav icon. For example, when you click here for Gmail, this is the fav icon. So for iWebsite also, we have created a fav icon. Make sure the fav icon is a square image. So select this thing, click on crop image. You can also create a fav icon from Logo Maker, obviously. So here it will appear, as you can see. Now we can get this fav icon over here. Once you're done that, click on save and publish. So we have successfully created our logo and our favicon. Now it's time to create the menu. So for that, come back to your dashboard. And hover appearances and select menus. What we have to do is create a new menu. It says menu name. You can put in any menu name. So I'm just putting it menu main or main menu, whatever you want. Click on create menu. Okay, so we don't want this sample page. So we click on here and click on remove. We want the home page, about us page, obviously. Now we want to add all this category into the menu. So we select all the category and click on add to menus. But we want our about us page and contact us page at the last. So what we do is click and hold on about us and drag it down. Similarly with the contact us page. So once you're done that, click on save menu. Now let's refresh the page and see how it looks. Okay, it doesn't show because we have not ticked this thing, main navigation. Just tick this thing and click on save menu now. Okay, so as you can see, now it shows the menu, the logo, everything. So with this, we have successfully created our blog. But this is not the end. After creating a blog, we have to do marketing of our blog. We have to do email marketing. We have to make it SEO friendly. So for that, I'll be making another video. For now, thank you for watching my video and make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next video, which is a very important video. And if you like this video, and I hope you like this video, just click on that like button and leave a comment below the video. If you have any doubt, anything, you can leave a comment and I'll try my best to give you a reply as soon as possible. So you can also watch my different videos. For example, I have created a video on how to create an e-commerce website using WordPress, how to create a social networking website using WordPress, and many different videos. So you can go ahead and watch all those videos. You will get a lot to learn from them. For now, thank you for watching. Stay